Hello, my name's Meredith, and I'd like to introduce you to Anvil. Anvil is a new way of building full-stack web apps with nothing but Python. I'm going to show it to you by building a secure, interactive app, complete with database storage and a user account, and publish it on the web, all in the next 6 minutes. And we won't need any JavaScript or HTML. All we need to know is basic Python. Ready? So, here I am in the Anvil editor. I'm going to create a new app and choose a visual theme. This here is our web page, and on this side is a toolbox of components we can drag onto it. We're going to start by building a Hello World app, which asks your name and then greets you. I'm going to start by placing a panel, and now I'll add a label to display some text. Down here we can see all the properties of the selected component. Text is the one we're interested in. We'll prompt the user to enter their name. Now I'll add a text box for them to do that. Each component has a name, so we can use it from code. We'll call this one NameBox. Now add a button for them to click. And finally, another label to display our greeting. We'll change some other properties here. We'll make it centered, make the text big, and so on. Finally, let's put a title on the page for good measure. Now we've designed our page visually, I can double-click this button, and now I'm editing the code that runs when this button gets clicked. Every page is a Python class, and we can see all the things we've just placed on it are accessible as instance variables. We want to change the text of the message label based on the text in the name box. So we do. That's it. Time to try it out. We've just built a simple web app. Let's publish it. Open the app menu and choose Publish. This is a private link. It's like a Google Docs sharing link. You can't open the app unless I send you the link. But we can make the app public instead, and give it a nicer URL. Now I can open helloworlddemo.anvilapp.net on any computer, or indeed on my phone. Anvil apps automatically work on small screens. Everything we've built so far runs in the browser. Even our Python code is compiled to JavaScript. Of course, most apps need something on the server as well. We can add a server module to our app. This is a Python module that runs on the server. No messing around with virtualenv, it's ready to go right away. To use it from client code, all we need to do is define a function. This one takes just one argument, name, and prints a greeting. If we decorate it with @anvil.server.callable, we can call it from our page. So let's do that. We just type anvil.server.call, and the autocompleter knows what we can call. It even knows it takes one argument, name, so we'll pass in the name box text. Run it again. And we see we have some output. The yellow background indicates that that was running on the server. This is just a Python module, so you can import anything you can pip install. If you want to talk to a database, just import the driver, connect, and away you go. But many apps need some sort of storage for themselves. Setting up a new database is a bore, but with Anvil, it's easy. The Data Tables service is an instant database with a pure Python API backed by PostgreSQL. We'll make a table to record the name of each visitor we've seen as a text column. Now, on the server, as well as printing out a greeting, we can add the name to the database. We take apptables.visitors, that's the new table we just created, and add a row, with the name column being the name we got from the page. Let's try it again. And if we go back to the tables, we can see that that name's been added. Let's recap. We've just built a database-backed web application and published it on the web in a little over 3 minutes. But there's so much more to Anvil that can make your life easier. For example, building user registration and login forms for every app can be a chore, so Anvil makes it easy. This one line of code is all you need. Anvil's user authentication is pretty powerful. As well as email and password, you can use Google or Facebook, or you can plug into your company's Active Directory or certificate system if you want to install Anvil inside your network. For now, let's stick with email and allow new signups as long as they confirm their email address. This table of users looks a bit like our visitors table from earlier. That's because it's just another data table. We can link them. For every visitor we record, we can store the user who was logged in when that name was entered. We want to show the login form when the app opens, so let's go to our page. This is the constructor, so it runs before the page opens. We'll show the login form, that's the one line of code we saw earlier. Now all we need is to store who was logged in when we save a name. In our server module, as well as the name, we now store the author. We can use anvil.users.getUser to get the table row for the current logged in user. Let's see it working. If I open the app, I see a login form. I'll need to sign up for a new account. Okay, I've got a confirmation email. I'll click the link. I'm confirmed. And now I'm back in the app, so I can log in and enter my name. Okay, if we look at the data table, not only is there a new row for the user I just created, but our new entry in the visitors table is linked to my user account. So we've built a secure multi-user database-backed web application and published it on the internet all in 6 minutes. Time to save my work. I'll click Save Version and make a note of what's changed. Anvil applications are fully version controlled. If I view history, I'm looking at the Git repository that holds my app. You can even check it out on your own computer if you want to. Now I've got this app working, I'm going to choose this version as the published version. This means I can keep working on my app, but anyone who visits the public URL gets the published version of the app. I hope you've enjoyed this introduction to Anvil. There's a lot more to explore. I'd recommend signing up yourself, then looking through our video tutorials and our reference documentation. Come and ask questions in our community forum and share what you've built with Anvil. I look forward to seeing you there.